What's up, guys? I'm Synthetic, and this is how I made the beat for Double.
All right, so shout out Synthetic for making that beat. Turned out crazy. But the one thing he did not cover is how to do the vocals. And that's what I'm going to show you how to do. Let's do it.
Big body, GLE, ski, I went body. My diamonds real busy, they potty. I'm finna pull up in Benz, no Audi. No, we know nobody. 20 bad bitches, they all in the lobby. Getting rich, like this is a hobby.
Okay, so here's the project right here, and before we do anything, I figured we should just do a little proof of concept, and let me show you guys that with this vocal preset, you can very easily sound like Yeet. Just to show you how this preset actually sounds, I recorded the song Double. I kind of tried to sound like Yeet. Obviously, my voice isn't Yeet, but I tried my best, and I think I did pretty well, so you guys could just listen and let me know what you think.
Big body, GLE, ski, I went body. My diamonds real busy, they potty. I'm finna pull up in Benz, no Audi. No, we know nobody. 20 bad bitches, they all in the lobby. Getting rich, like this is a hobby. Pull up in and talk, yeah, this is me, buddy, me, buddy, me, buddy.
So yeah, before we do anything else, I'm just going to show you guys how this actually sounds live. Obviously, this preset is called the Yeet Double Preset. It looks like this. It's available at my website, quintibaba.com. There's also a link down in the description below. You want to cop it there. There's a Waves version and an FL Studio stock version. I personally use the Waves version, but they pretty much sound the same. The biggest difference is just the Waves interface, in my opinion, looks a lot better. It's just easier to understand. But yeah, let me show you guys what this sounds like live real quick.
All right, so this is what it sounds like. And I'm just going to record a little take after this.
Hey! Big body, GLE, ski, I went body. My diamonds real pissy, they potty. I'm finna pull up in Benz, nobody. No, we know nobody. 20 bad bitches, they all in the lobby. Getting rich, like this is a hobby. Pull up in the Tonka, yeah, this is B-Body, B-Body, B-Body. Pull up in the Tonka, yeah, this is B-Body, 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 B-Body. Everybody can get lit, they like this and they wouldn't, they wouldn't even say that about it. Say it again for the kids, they just doubt it. Why do I sell it left with their closet, y'all be cleaning up. Go ahead, chop it up like a mine. Let it go.
Okay, so I think that gives you a bit of some proof of concept to show you that this actually sounds good. So let's just break down the preset now. So like I said, this is the Waves version. I'm going to show you guys both, but they sound the same. So for the Waves version, if you go to the website, you can see all the plugins you actually need, but this is what we are using. We got Auto-Tune Pro. You could obviously use any Auto-Tune you want. You could use the Waves Tune if you want to. You could also use FL Studio Pitcher if you don't have any of the other ones. But the key is in F minor. We have the retune speed basically all the way up. You see it's at 3 and the humanize at 13 just to smooth it out a bit. Then we have NS1 and all this does is just bring some of the noise out of the vocal. It's basically just a noise gate. Then we have our first EQ and I'm using Fab Filter and it's pretty much just your typical EQ pattern. I notice a lot of times in Yeet's vocals, he does leave a bit more low end in there, so I'm kind of trying to leave some of that low end in there a bit more, but we're pretty much just pulling out some of those lower mids and just kind of evening out the vocal, making it sound a lot more smooth. And of course, we're bringing up the high end. Then we have a de-esser. If you don't know what a de-esser is, all it does is any sibilance in your voice, which is basically the high end, any of like the s, any of that, basically just pulls that out and makes the voice sound a little bit more smooth and less harsh. We move on to our first compressor. I like to EQ DS to get that vocal really smooth. And then we go into our first compressor. And when you get this preset, I do think you should mess around with the compression a bit yourself just because it's going to be different for every mic. I have this set to mine, so I'm recording with my input gain sitting around, I want to say, minus 12 to minus 15. So we have the threshold at minus 22.8. And we have a ratio set to 5.49 to 1. And then the attack is a pretty fast attack and a pretty fast release. This is pretty much normal on all my compressors. I usually keep the attack a bit faster than the release. And this just allows you to have a very normal sounding vocal. It doesn't take too much away from your vocal and it doesn't add too much. Then we have the SSL E channel, which is just an EQ, and this is basically Waves trying to simulate a solid state logic board, which is just a piece of hardware that people used to use back in the day to mix vocals, and this is just trying to simulate it. So what we're doing in here is just using this red knob to bring up some of the high end. Screen knob right here is the high mids, and if you really want to see what this is using 8000 kilohertz right here and right in the middle of 3 to 4.5 kilohertz right here. So that is the high mids. Then we have our low mids and I'm bringing a little bit out, and then we have our basically like a high pass filter right here. And as you can see, I'm not even adjusting that because like I said, we do want to leave some of that low end in there. And we have my favorite compressor of all time. If you know me, you know this compressor is my favorite. Your input and output don't really matter too much. You're just going to adjust this to how loud you really want. Basically, you don't really touch this output at all. Your input, just adjust it until you're getting about -3 to -5 decibels. And like I said before, the attack and release are pretty much the same as the R compressor. A pretty fast attack sitting like right in the mids, and then an even faster release. Maybe a Fresh Air, if you don't have this, go grab it. It's free. Great plugin. It's kind of like a vocal saturation plugin, and it just makes your vocal sound super crispy. And we have another EQ, and if you have FabFilter Pro Q3, what you could do is actually make certain bands in this EQ. You can turn it into a compressor. It's like a multi-band compressor. Basically, what I did is when I'm trying to leave that low end in the Yeet vocal, sometimes that low end will really muddy up your mix. So I wanted to control it. I didn't want to take it out, but I wanted to squeeze it, you know, compress it down and just make it fit in the mix. And that's about it on our main vocal. Then we have our ad-lib track. And the only difference here is I added the Fruitio stereo shaper and we put it on the Stereoize 2 preset. This just makes it sound wider in your headset. And we also brought this knob to exactly 50%. And then when you get the waves, it comes with a reverb bus track and a delay bus track. And basically what this is, a bus track is just, it allows you to control your reverb better. And all you do to do this is say this track right here, 15, say this is your main vocal and this is your reverb bus. All you're going to do is go to your main vocal and click this button. And as you can see, now you can adjust how much of the reverb you want. Obviously, all the way up, you're going to have a super reverb dense track. All the way down, you're going to have no reverb at all. But like I said, this is our main vocal right here, and it's going over to this reverb bus right here. And I have my reverb set to 24% on the main vocal. And then we're using the 1/4 delay, and we have that set to about 14%. And then the ad-lib track, like I said, it's the same thing. It just has the stereo shaper on there. And we're also bringing the reverb up to 52%, and then the delay is at 48%. Now we're going to go over the main part of the Yeet ad-libs. This is like the most important part. This is how you get that, like, I don't even know how to explain it. It's just that Yeet ad-lib effect. And I did a video on this before, so if you want to go watch that, I also go a little bit into detail. But the easiest way to do it is if you have AutoTune Pro, which is what I'm using. I have this track called the High Pitch track. And as you can see, we have a Fruity Reverb on it and an AutoTune Pro. And in this AutoTune, we have it set the same exact way. The retune speed is just a little bit less down. F minor again. And then what we're doing here is the biggest, most important part is right here. Transpose knob. We're bringing it up 12 semitones. And like I said, when you do that one part, you click this button down here, you bust that track out. What we're doing is busting the ad-lib track out to this high pitch knob. As you can see, basically what I did here, we have it sitting at 68%. So I'm going to take it off, but you're going to go to your ad-lib track. And you can just go ahead and make this track yourself. Like I said, it's super easy. You just put that autotune on there and transpose it up 12 semitones. And then you bust it out by clicking this button. And like we said, we want it at 68%. And I'm going to show you guys the difference. So we're going to solo out the ad-libs. So if I play it with all the effects on, this is what it's going to sound like. So I think like the best way to describe that is like it's kind of like a whining sound. So let me turn it off so you can get a better idea. That's without, and here's with. I mean, it just sounds so much better. But yeah, that's the way to do it with AutoTune. And if you don't have AutoTune, there's another way to do it. I'm going to show you guys exactly how. So we're going to take this off, and all you're going to do is duplicate this over. You have two of them. Make it unique. Pitch it up. You're basically going to get the same effect here, but it's going to be way overbearing right now because it's going to be too loud. But all you got to do is just turn that down. And there you go. You get the same exact effect. So you can do it with stock or without, but obviously I think the way with AutoTune is just a bit easier than having to duplicate it over, make it unique, and then bring it up a semitone. And you could just adjust it with the one track. Yeah, that's it with the Waves edition. So let's go into the stock one. I'll show you guys how I did that. So here's the stock version, and we're just going to quickly go over what I did here. So we have two EQs in the beginning. We're using this first one to just shape that vocal initially. Then we got the second one just pulling out any of those bad frequencies that we hear in the room. Then we got our limiter. And I think this is just a noise gate. Yeah, I'm just using this as a noise gate. Just this part right here. So it's cutting out any of the, like if you got a fan on in the background, it'll cut that out. We got a multi-band compressor. In my opinion, this is what really makes the vocal. It's really controlling the vocal and just bringing out the high end, controlling that low end, and just sprinkling some good tones into that mid-band. We got our sound goodizer. This is basically like Fresh Air. Kind of just saturates the vocal. It also compresses it a bit. Then we got our first limiter, which we're just using the compression tab right here with these settings. Then we got a reverb, delay, and a flangus. And then the ad-lib track, all I did was duplicate the same exact track over, and we brought the reverb up, the delay up a bit too, and that flangus up a lot too. And also, I brought some of that low end out in this mix. Yeah, that's all I got for the video. So if you guys enjoyed this one, make sure you go down, hit that like button for me. Also, hit that subscribe button. I mean, you might as well. I'm going to be dropping a bunch more Yeet videos. We got this new camera. I mean, might as well hit that subscribe button. Like I said, everything is down in the description below if you want to cop any of the presets. If you thought if you thought FL Studio looked a little bit different in this video, it's because I'm using my mixing template. That's what I use in FL Studio just to mix a little bit easier. Makes everything a lot easier to mess around with. Yeah, that's all I got. I'll see you guys in the next video.